Finding me proved no simple task, for having fallen afoul of Novigrad's underworld bosses, I'd disappeared. Yet Geralt soon discovered my whereabouts, a cell in the dungeon of the Temple Guard. With the help of our friends, Geralt managed to free me. Good thing, too, for indeed I knew what had happened to Ciri. Sadly, she was no longer in Novigrad. Pursued by bandits, and cornered by the Temple Guard, she had disappeared in a flash of light and a gust of heat. Where to? This I did not know.
The last individual who tried to come in on my business, it took them a month to find him. Am I being clear, Chive?
What's the fuss about? Can you not treat me as a bit of healthy competition?
Why are you even talking to him, Duke? I've always maintained two smashed knees are worth a thousand words.
Oh, Geralt! Glad you came.
There a problem?
A problem? There's some kind of problem here, gents. Oh, just wanted you to meet my new pals before they bugger the fuck off. Because we're just parting, right?
We'll have our reckoning yet, Chive. Soon.
What's this? Some flea-ridden mutant got you scared, Duke? Just say the word. I'll take care of him. Take a peek at what he's got inside, then make the midget eat it. Sound good?
Next time, Earl. Let's go.
Right. And don't show your hides round here ever again. Well, that puts me up to the neck in fucking shite without the shovel.
Shady, those guys. Who were they?
Puffed up fish bladders, Duke. Word does he's out to be the new horse son Junior, but the bugger's missing a hell of a lot. Specifically coin, influence, men, and class.
And the other?
Errol. A scumjug like few others. Skin of my arse twitches at the sight of him. Back in Mahakam, we'd send sow buggers like that down the coalface with a bundle of powder and a leaky lamp.
What's this all about? Doing business with them?
Exactly the ploughing opposite. You see, Geralt, old pal...
About to ask me for help, aren't you?
The thing is, I sort of kind of owe a wee sum to a mutual acquaintance, Francis Bedlam, the King of Beggars. To pay off the debt, I've made up my mind to get serious about Gwent.
Getting better by the minute.
Not the playing of it, mind you, but the cards themselves. Rarest of them fetch princely sums these days. Sadly, that's not exactly arcane knowledge. Got a buyer in heat for my collection, missing just three cards. But Duke's dregs are all over my arse, so... What do you say, Geralt?
Fine. We'll try to hunt down those cards. Which ones you need?
Fringilla, Vigo, Isengrim, and John Natalis. Devilish hard to get hold of. Duke's been trying too, hasn't had any luck.
Wait, you don't even know where to look for these cards?
Nah, it's not as bad as that. I'm betting Zed's got them. He quit fencing recently, only deals in cards now. Unfortunately, the arsewipe won't talk to me. Not after I bought a one-of-a-kind Scoia'tael card out from under his nose. Would you mind going to see him?
Zed? Sounds familiar.
Big fish in the card pond. There's a shop along the south wall. And thank you, Geralt. I actually think I stand to pay off this debt now.
No problem. See you later, Zoltan.
Is this truly what you want?
Hey there,
to be perverse cheap whores and watered down wine.
Hey, I piss me trousers.
You can't control what I inherit.
But you can control what you do.
I'll give you a discount.
I know.
For heroic
I know,
deeds,
which is exactly
madam,
why I'm considering.
Well,
oh, we can go.
You're
it
always
here.
Considering. If it's not one thing, it's another. Let me know when you finally decide.
What was that about?
She spat in my face. Or might as well have. Called me a whoremonger and a witless hack. Can you imagine? Wit is my forte.
Gotta say, Priscilla's really growing on me.
save it.
And why don't you save your pouting? Prove to her she's wrong.
Exactly what I plan to do. I've always dreamed of having my own cabaret. A bit of paint and plaster, and this place will do splendidly. Just one hitch. I need coin. So, if you happen to get a break between drowners and ekamajigs, maybe you can help an old friend out.
Where do you get this cabaret idea?
It's been a dream for years. Ever since we went to see one in Oxenford. Remember? The dancer hanging from the chandelier? And once she was completely downside up, she called you over and...
I remember.
How could you forget? And this place will be even better, I promise. That is, of course, if I can scrounge together the funds for some remodeling.
How can I help you?
I dated this girl once, Sophronia. That's a name if you can believe it. Has a merchant for a father, importer of spices from Zeracania. And Daddy Dear would never refuse his daughter Dear a thing. We can borrow the coin from her.
Name rings a bell. Isn't this the woman you abandoned without saying a word? Stepped out for a bottle of wine, never to return?
I bought that wine for a reason.
Long time ago, that.
Been away a while, sure. Which is why I need to draw on your authority. You've got some, you know. No matter what you might think.
Fine. Tell me what you want. Got a feeling you've a plan all cooked up.
Sophronia could still be holding a grudge after our unfortunate parting. But with a touch of help from you, I know she'll forgive me, and then give me that loan.
What's this help entail?
First of all, we need to borrow a dull sword from Madame Irina, one of her props. You know, the kind they use during performances? Get that, then meet me outside Sophronia's house.
Let's say I agree and go see Madame Irina. What will you be doing in the meantime?
Something I have to finish. But I promise I'll do it before you come back with the sword. Then I'll tell you the rest.
Fine, but...
Geralt, the only buts in this plan will be the ones filling my seats. It'll work, you'll see. Get the sword from Madame Irina and meet me outside Sophronia's at sunset.
What's he schemed up this time?
Now you.
Truth is, we're already dependent on
the
Blackwaters. Economically.
Ah, so good to see you.
Got a request. Need to borrow one of your props. One of the swords you use for stage battles.
My. Whatever do you need that for?
I don't know. But Dandelion claims it's essential.
Oh, yes. I suspected Master Dandelion might have a hand in this. I certainly hope you don't aim to compete with me. Au revoir.
Thanks. I'll try not to damage it. So long.
Ah, so good to see you.
You and Dudu know each other well?
Yes, though he's never told me much about himself. He was a merchant once?
Mm-hmm. Dudu always had a penchant for enterprise. Probably too honest to succeed in Novigrad, though.
Precisely. I've told him countless times that no matter how many times he changes his appearance, the good in him will always emerge. Bloodthirsty tyrants and vicious assassins. He played them so poorly. That must be why. Whereas he always made for an excellent trusted servant or ghost of the old king.
Take care.
Finally made it. Listen, here's the plan. Sophronia loves adventure-filled romance novels. I can be a hero in her eyes if I can just save her from a bandit. I'll have her eating out of my hand, and there's no way she'll begrudge me that loan.
Want me to be the bandit?
Knew you'd see the sense in it right away.
Are you serious? That's your brilliant plan?
I never called it brilliant. But any kind of plan is better than none. Written your lines already.
You've written what?
So you know what to say during the performance. Here, Andromask, put it on. Sophronia can't recognize you.
But...
No time. Sophronia's coming. Stick to the plan. We'll meet at the Rosemary in the morning.
Stop right there.
What is this?
Not your lucky day, miss. Hand me your purse, now.
Not so fast. Drop your sword, scoundrel. This is your first and last warning.
Dandelion!
'Tis I, though the scum of the city call me the Crimson Avenger.
More like the Crimson Asshole.
Silence, vermin! You shall regret the day you were born.
Come on!
You're better than I thought.
Go on, Dandelion! I mean, Crimson Avenger!
The Crimson Avenger triumphs again.
Are you well?
One blow struck true. Another scar from my collection.
Come inside. I shall bandage you up. Be gone, vile bandit, or the Crimson Avenger will beat you senseless!
Don't know what the fucking problem is.
Well, not a freak.
There's been a misunderstanding. You're here too early.
We agreed to meet today, so we've come today. Supplies are all hauled in and the crew's raring to work. We'll start just as soon as our lovely directress gets round to deciding on the decoration.
But Dandelion doesn't even have the coin to pay you.
Turns out he does now, or soon will. At any rate, he's working on it.
See? It's all peachy. So will you finally decide what style you want for this interior?
Why are you asking me?
Well, the lovely lady seems to be having a hard time deciding. And Master Dandelion said he was torn between boudoir style and theatre decor, but that he'd let us know just as soon as we arrived. Now we're here, but no decision's been made. And the lady's horribly surprised she's to choose. Though apparently this whole renovation's for her sake.
For me?
Well, it's not for me. Now, would you please decide for I bust a vessel?
I've no idea what Dandelion would like. Geralt, you've known him longer. Say something.
Sure, I've known him longer, but he's never so much as changed his socks for me. Never mind commissioning a full-blown renovation. He's doing this for you, clearly. You should decide.
I associate boudoirs with a feminine elegance that also has an edge. Claws, you might say. That fits a cabaret perfectly.
A wonderful choice it is. At last. Gentlemen, you're done lollygagging. Get to work.
Well, well. Guess this cabaret is the real thing.
Ever since Dandelion inherited this place, he's talked about it constantly. I just never expected him to take action. And so quickly.
Who knows? Might even settle down now. He'll have to keep an eye on the business. Who would have known?
Despite what people say about him, Dandelion approaches life very rationally.
We talking about the same Dandelion? Man who loses a fortune worth half of Novigrad in one night?
Dandelion can also be responsible. He always pays anyone who works for him on time, and he's never missed a performance.
Sure hope your opening won't be the first. He's still not here.
Well, he said as soon as he got the coin, he'd go see Polly, our choreographer. She's missed the last few rehearsals. I certainly hope he's not gotten into trouble.
Anything's possible with Dandelion. Let me see if I can't find him.
I'd give you a discount for heroic deeds, but the madam, well, you know.
The ruckus about.
Polly and her half-brained fiancé. They're fighting. She's the only one in this town who knows anything about choreography, and that lummox won't let her work for me. Hold on. What are you doing here? We were gonna meet at the Rosemary.
We were, but you didn't show. Priscilla started to worry, so I came to see how you were doing.
Priscilla started worrying about me? That's so nice!
Less for her than for you, I'm sure. So let's get back.
Did you not hear what's going on in there? We've gotta help Polly! Why do beautiful women always end up with such dicks?
No idea. Stand back. I'll break the door down.
Wait! Do we have to destroy her house? She keeps a spare key around here somewhere.
How would you know she keeps a spare key around here?
It's not as if we started working together yesterday. Before Polly joined forces with Hubio...
You'd visit her? Often?
I'd hide out here while Priscilla and Polly rehearsed at the Rosemary in Time. They worked on the dance numbers. I composed.
So, Polly's not one of your...
I never mix business and pleasure.
The one exception being Priscilla.
Who you were just saying is worried about us. So enough of the chatter, and start looking.
Fine. Let's find the key.
Find anything?
Not here. The key.
Damn it. Now, where would she leave?
Whoa! What the devil's this? Get out of my house!
Watch it, and leave the woman alone.
What the... She's my betrothed!
But I'm not your property!
I love her! I'll not let her sway her ass in his brothel!
Whoa! Slow down there a minute. This is clearly one gigantic misunderstanding. One I can clear up in the blink of an eye.
Shove your excuses up your ass. Sod off, or I'll split your skull.
My friend asked you nicely, so please be courteous in return and hear him out, or we'll settle this another way.
All right, talk.
Hubio, right? Polly's told me so much about you. She said you're erudite and have an open mind.
You said that? Well, there's a truth to it. My mind's the open salt, but its open-saltedness ends when my betrothed starts wagging her ass around brothels. Get out of here, both of yous. Polly's not going anywhere.
Let him finish. There's no brothel involved.
You see, friend, Geralt just hit the nail on the head. For what you have there is the old publicity placard.
old?
Very. From a time when my establishment was under different management. I, however, would never let any indecency take place in my cabaret. My very reputation precludes it.
So, what's all this about?
Your betrothed is a first-class artiste, and I want to offer her a position worthy of her talents. She's to be my choreographer, and that in turn means she'll receive a share of the proceeds from every performance she choreographs.
You mean to say coin?
And fame. No flirting required. You have my word.
Suppose, in that case...
I knew you'd agree.
It's settled then. See you at the Rosemary, Polly.
Well, I'm off.
I'll catch up to you. Whew. Never expected that to go so well.
You handled it well, Dandelion. Man was body in your hands once you called him erudite.
In negotiation, as in combat, the key is to find your opponent's weak spot and exploit it to the hilt.
So, time to head back?
I've still got to stop by Rotlix. Commissioned some new placards from him a while ago, but Hubio came across the old version. Plowing artists got some serious explaining to do.
Who's Rotlick?
Never heard of him? Hank Rotlick, famous portrait artist?
Commissioned a portrait artist to paint your placards?
Henry's an old friend, needed the coin. And I decided we needed new placards to promote the opening performance. Seats won't fill themselves, you know.
I'll go see Rotlick. You head back to the Rosemary, or Priscilla will have my head.
Really? You'd go?
No, said that for the hell of it. Tell me where he lives.
Portside.
See you soon.
Alone. Damn halflings in debt to half the city, but I'm here to scrape mine before the carcass is picked clean.
There's not enough for everyone, so bugger off. Feeding time's first come, first served.
You're not gonna rob him.
Strange, don't recall asking your permission. Get him, Fred! No! Mutant! Vehicle but estate. Losing his last crowns at the races.
See, wasn't that easy? Could have said so right away.
You're a considerable sum in the red, but you shan't back out on that account, eh?
You won't have much of a choice before long.
Come now, old sport. We can't allow that. Who'd I wager it then, eh? Listen, here's what we'll do. We'll make one more bet. If you win, I'll pay your debts and we'll continue playing. What do you say?
And if I lose?
One worry at a time, old chum. Well, I'm off to place my bet.
You, Rotlick?
Henry Rotlick? Artist, painter, debtor, and martyr to my art. At your service.
Dandelion sent me.
Oh, yes. Tell him his placards are done and safely hidden away. Yet, alas, I cannot fetch them. as a group of angry creditors has seized my home.
Think I might have run into one of them.
Then you know my predicament. And now Count de Louverdin has offered me the chance to win it all back. I'm to wager on a race.
Generous. Not just anybody could afford to do that.
De Louverdin is not just anybody. He's Duke Sam's youngest son. Sam of the well-known family of gem dealers. One debt more or less makes little difference to him.
What's there to worry about? This is your chance to settle up, get a clean slate.
We've had a spell of bad luck lately. Should I agree to de Louverdin's offer and lose, I shall be in bondage to him for all time.
Let me pay off your debt. No strings attached.
Thank you. I never expected this. May I ask to what I owe this generosity?
Let's just say I like to do a good deed from time to time. Can we get those placards now?
I'll bring them to the Rosemary in time. Just as soon as I settle my obligations.
Fine. See you there.
Oh!
Gods and men, dumbstruck with awe! Behold, madly galloping poetry!
The youth these days, hair-brained all.
Wondering if I could take part in the races.
If you've coin for the rider's fee and a steed of your own, why not? Decide quickly, please. There's a race about to begin.
I want a race.
Grand. Your name and the name of your steed.
Geralt of Rivia. On Roach.
Excellent. Your opponent, let me see. Seamus Holt astride Athos.
Got it right.
What do you want?
To express my admiration on account of your victory. And here, brought you an invitation from the boss. He'd like to congratulate you personally. Farewell.
Thanks for the invite.
Congratulations. Quite the winner, the Vagal Butts. Luke's one hell of a prick, but I don't recall him ever losing before. And seeing as you outran him, you actually stand a chance at Palio. Make some real coin.
Palio? Never heard of it.
Fuck me, what a peasant. The Palio's a race held at night in the city streets. Used to be every district sponsored a competitor. Things are different now. You're gonna race jockeys put forward by Bedlam and Reuven, but my coin's on you.
Fine, I'll race.
Lovely, colour me thrilled. Just don't bloody let me down, cause I'm about to bet a small fortune on you. Go prepare. Drink some chamomile or whatever the fuck you do.
The Palio is above all a race of honour. The winner doesn't just win a reward, he earns our respect as well. So, take your positions and get the fuck going!
Let's go!
Cleaver had a good hunt for proving you. Congratulations.
Slow now. Whoa.
Give us a kiss, Geralt.
No? Then I'll smooch that roach of yours. That were lovely.
And my pay?
Take it, you cheeky bastard. Never met a man who earned his coin fairer than you did today.
Temple Guard! Scatter!
We gotta get the fuck out of here. Thanks, Geralt.
In the evening, a performance by the illustrious duo, Master Dandelion and Priscilla!
The piece is sad, melancholy. Needs a minor key.
But I wanted to.
To ruin everything. We're starting here.
Well, well. See, the crew's been hard at work. Not bad.
No. No, not all. But I'd imagine something more, you know, more theatrical.
Don't you like it? But I thought a boudoir would be right in line with your tastes.
Oh, you chose it. Well, I'm not saying it's bad. Just different. Not exactly what I'd envisaged. You know, now that I think about it, you're absolutely right. A boudoir is the perfect setting for a cabaret. What about Rotlick? Did you get the placards?
Rotlick said he'd bring them on his own. Should be here soon.
Great! The best way I can think of to promote the chameleon.
What about choreography? Prepared anything special for the opening?
We haven't. But Polly has. She's priceless. Came in and brought the girls in line before I could say knickers. Premier will have the audience on their feet, on their knees, both at the same time.
Never mentioned wanting to change the name.
Rosemary and Thyme wasn't all bad. But it conjured images of Temerian cuisine served by waitresses in peasant garb. Chameleon's a lot better for a cabaret, apart from which it emphasizes that the place has undergone a transformation. Just a better ring to it all round.
Guess everything's ready. So when's the opening?
Soon. We start our dress rehearsal in an hour. I just need to nip back home for my dress.
Thanks for everything.
Don't mention it.
Seems my cabaret dreams are about to come true. So, around to celebrate? I'm buying.
Why not?
That's my boy. The foreman mentioned he saw you and Priscilla talking.
He saw right.
And she say anything about me?
She said something that made me think she's not entirely normal.
What?
That you're responsible, got your feet planted firmly on the ground.
You're pulling my leg.
Not this time. One thing's eating me. How do you manage to get the loan from Sophronia?
Ugh, wasn't easy. She got so excited about our performance, I had to read to her for 4 hours. 4 hours from the cloak and the dagger.
You mean you didn't?
Are you crazy? Who do you think I am? She's late, of course. She knew how important this night was to me.
Of course she did. Probably just making herself gorgeous. Takes time, you know.
So it's true. A woman's vanity knows no bounds.
Master Dandelion! Priscilla, she's...
What? Speak, man!
She's badly, been attacked. They took her to Vormerius Hospital.
Attacked? She's hurt? Geralt, come with me, please.
Of course. Let's go.
Gods. Priscilla. Is she gonna live?
Well, I'd say that's certain. Her condition's critical but stable. Beg your pardon, but you are a relative?
Relative? No, a friend. A very close friend.
Dandelion, correct? She uttered the name in her few moments of lucidity. I am Joachim von Gratz, head of surgery. Until recently, a lecturer at Oxenfurt Academy.
Enough of the courtesies. What are her injuries, besides her eye?
A concussion, cranial swelling, incision into her larynx, and scalding inside the throat and esophagus. Clearly someone forced her to imbibe a caustic fluid.
So this was no ordinary attack, no robbery.
Clearly not. It was the act of a demented mind, and not its first.
How can you know that?
I've seen wounds like this. They're not the kind one would forget, don't you agree? In fact, just this week, a corpse turned up in the morgue with similar injuries. And no heart.
No heart? You mean that might have happened to Priscilla? Is someone looking into this?
This is Novigrad. Only the innocent burn here.
Geralt, I know I owe you 100 times over, but I need to ask you another favor. Find the bastard who did this. Find him. And kill him.
Don't need any convincing. Come on, Dandelion. Let's think about what we can do.
I would suggest examining the previous victim's corpse. It has yet to be autopsied. Doing so could very well provide some clues. No need to look astonished, gentlemen. As a surgeon, I know the importance of preventive medicine. Rather than wait for this maniac to strike again, I'd prefer to excise him. Not unlike a tumor.
Great analogy, but this tumor's not gonna sit there, wait to be excised. Appreciate the help, but I doubt you know what you're getting yourself into.
I know perfectly well, and I assure you I can take care of myself.
Easy assurance to make, harder to back up, especially if you've spent your whole life wielding a scalpel, not a sword.
Look at this scar. Don't be shy. Any idea what leaves such a mark?
A flail. Morning Star, maybe.
What do you think? A blow sustained at the operating table? No? Let me repeat, I know what I'm doing, and I wish to help.
Think they'll let me into the morgue?
By the main entrance, certainly not. But you can also get inside through the sewers.
The sewers? Travel them often, Doctor?
As often as required for, the pursuit of preventive medicine.
Alternative treatments. Aggressive ones, I'm guessing. Interesting.
We can discuss this en route. Are you ready?
Mm-hmm. Ready and intrigued. I'll get whoever did this, Dandelion. Even if it's Hierarch Himmelfarb himself.
Thanks.
You lead.
So, preventive medicine you practice in the sewers. What's that about?
Think. Sewing up drowner victims can grow awfully tedious. Is it not better to nip the problem and hear that?
Been hearing it for a while. Draw your weapon.
Hey! Help! Help!
Come on!
Sugarcoating.
Her wounds will heal, but it's her voice that concerns me. Surely you understand what a terrible blow that would be to a Trobriks. Enough to strip her of the will to live.
Any remedy for that?
I fear only your friend Dandelion can be of help on that count. Take the ladder. This is the place. Come, the quicker we take care of this, the better.
Why? Got somewhere to be?
Someone might disturb us. The coroner, for example. Or Reverend Nathaniel Pastodi. Very well. We seek the corpse of a dwarven woodcarver.
Human. Wrong body type. Looks like necrophage has got to this one. Gotta be him.
But this one's a she. Remember, beards are no indicator of gender amongst dwarves.
A dwarf, but the hands. Not a carpenter's. A banker's, more likely. Let's keep looking. Calluses on the fingers, sawdust in the beard, clothes sticky with sap. Must be our dwarf.
Excellent. I trust you don't grow weak in the knees at the sight of blood?
Not a bit. Start the autopsy.
Where?
Let's look at his head. Hair smells like it's burnt, like he was in a fire.
Notice anything else? That his eyes have been scooped out, for instance?
Those burn marks I see in his eye sockets.
Yes, and some gray dust. Ash, it seems. Very fine.
Murderer gouged out his eyes, then put burning coals in the sockets.
So it seems. Looking at the wounds, it appears our woodcarver was still alive when it happened.
Let's examine the mouth. Burns, blisters.
Just like Priscilla's.
See this? Incision made into the voice box.
In Indeed, so thin as to be nearly unnoticeable.
A small, extremely sharp instrument. Scalpel.
But why? The wound is too small to bleed, and there are signs of swelling. The murderer... I believe he performed a tracheotomy, so the victim wouldn't die too soon.
Let's examine his torso.
What have we here? Deep wound on the left side of his rib cage, and a scar the length of his stomach.
Let's examine the chest wound. Yeah, heart carved out, wound cauterized.
Wait a minute, there's something else.
An egg from an amphibian. A salamander? Scorched but intact.
I attended some lectures in herpetology as a student. Afraid I don't recall any amphibians that would lay eggs in corpses. So either Professor Cochrane was deeply mistaken, or this is our murderer's doing.
Look at the scar. Wounds long and thin, an incision. But the edges are ragged.
Means nothing. Look, no swelling, no bruises. An old injury, perhaps an accident in the workplace.
Open the abdominal cavity.
Due warning, it will stink of rot.
Once fought a Zugel up to my waist in sewage, so I doubt... Wait. Smells not rot.
Formaldehyde. A medical novelty. Heavily diluted, it's remarkable at preserving organic tissue. In stronger proportions, it's more destructive than acid.
Explains why there's no smell of decay, and why his throat scalded. Look at his hands. These welts. Rope burns, right? He was tied up.
I'd expect so. No one could sit through such torture unless bound.
Speaking from experience?
Yes, that of a victim. Spent a year in the dungeons of Tretagor. Long story.
Some other time, maybe. See the callus? Our dwarf wore a ring, but someone took it off him. See anything interesting on his legs?
His right foot. The ankle swollen, toenails broken. He clearly kicked something very hard. Right before he kicked the bucket.
Doesn't strike me as the right time for jokes.
Apologies, we surgeons. We've a different sensibility.
Mm-hmm. And a different sense of humor. His genitals. We ought to inspect those.
I sincerely doubt they bear any relation to the matter.
Right. Never mind. All right. Think I know enough.
Enlighten me, please, because I've still no notion what this is about. What the motive might have been.
It's some kind of sick ritual. You saw it. Burns in the eye sockets. Cavity where the heart should be, scalding liquid, all centering on warmth, heat, fire.
A fire eternal.
It's a lead worth following. Any idea what his name was?
Fabian Meyer. And I'm Hubert Reich, the coroner. I've come to perform the autopsy, but I see you've done it for me, Joachim. As always, you interfere where you're neither needed nor wanted, drag others into trouble in the process. Who is this?
A student. Lifelong learner. Got a couple questions for you.
Very well, speak. But be quick. Reverend Nathaniel has come by for an inspection. He'll be here shortly.
You old friends?
Hubert taught me the rudiments of medicine. Long ago.
And not very well. You've still not mastered certain basic principles. For example, that a doctor's role is to treat the ill, not save the world.
You've not changed a bit.
A compliment?
No, a statement of fact. 30 years, and you've not changed a bit.
woodcarver's body. Where was it found? It's important.
Plan to investigate? Exciting. He died in his workshop south of the market square, just beside the gate to Far Corners. That poor Trebirats was attacked there. City's abuzz about it. But the woodcarver, Eustace the corpse collector, brought us the body. You should speak to him. Saw him just around the corner near... Oh, greetings, Your Reverence.
Who are these people? I believe I made it clear no one was to be allowed in under any circumstances.
You did, but they're friends of the deceased. Here to collect the body.
Out of the question. Show them out at once.
As Your Reverence wishes. Gentlemen, follow me. You shall leave via another route.
Why do you cover for us?
I was covering my own arse. If Reverend Nathaniel had learned someone had entered the morgue, then cut open a corpse without his permission, I'd be in deep trouble. But you didn't give that a thought, did you, Joachim? As ever. Well, while I don't approve of your willfulness, I also wish to see this murderer hang. So, should I learn anything new related to this case, I will let you know.
Thank you.
Nathaniel, who is he?
A scoundrel, a rogue, like every man who wears the robes of the Eternal Fire.
Most are scoundrels before they ever put on the robes.
True in his case as well. Before he donned the frock, Nathaniel was a torturer, delighted especially in torturing women. Later, Hierarch Himmelfahrt appointed him to oversee the morgue. He deals with the Temple Guard, supervises cremations, conducts funeral masses in the temple on the Isle, and so forth.
Dream job. Might have told me you know the coroner. We could have skipped the trip through the sewers.
I know him, thus I avoid him. I've said enough on the subject.
Don't aim to press you.
Thank you. I've nothing to hide. It's just an old wound, unhealed as yet. What will you do now?
Plenty of leads. Woodcarver's workshop, the corpse collector who found him, alley where Priscilla was attacked. Got work to do.
As do I. At the hospital. I must return there. But I shall keep my fingers crossed.
And I'll keep my eye on you.
That's not your stomping ground.
Hey, handsome.
A brazier. This time of year? Man's footprints. The murderer's maybe.
How
wait on
I
his
know?
Heel.
Watch him, see what
took
he does.
A step back.
Take him from the back!
Together now! Kill the horse!
Gotta knock you clean, you lad!
Think you'll gut me too, huh? Up your ass, deviant! Horse can fight back!
Calm down, I'm not gonna hurt you. What are you doing here?
Getting vengeance. Well, why are you staring? Have you not heard killers always return to the scene of their crime? Me and my brothers are waiting here to give him a warm welcome. For Priscilla. Almost did her in, the whole son.
I know. Here to look for clues and find anyone who might know something.
Fear I can't help you much. But I can tell you what I know.
Priscilla wasn't the sole victim. You aware of that?
Oh, dearie. Of course I was. This didn't start yesterday. Others have died like this before. Beggars, street girls, orphans. But who'd have a drama concern about them? Human rubbish. It's what the guards call us.
Recall any names?
They didn't have proper ones.
baldy, curly buns. That's what folk called them. No friends, no families. Their bodies were burned long ago.
You and Priscilla friends?
Friends? Nah. But she saw more than a stupid hoe in me. Treated me with respect. It mattered. I was looking to give up whoring, pick up a decent trade. But none would take me. Not as a washerwoman, nor a servant, nor a cook. Felt like a leper, I did. But Priscilla, she was different. Agreed to put me in her play, you see? Lots of the other actors, they were afraid on account of her jesting about the eternal fire. Whistling Wendy on stage, can you imagine it? Well, dream's gone now. I'm back to working street corners.
Sorry to hear that.
You could do worse as work goes. Or so I tell myself.
Take care now. I gotta look around some more. Appreciate it if you didn't disturb me.
Naturally. We'll stand aside, behave. But do tell us if you find anything else here.
Oh, me head's ringing. Awful pipe. Oh, me head's ringing.
A brazier. This time of year? Human. Priscilla's. Man's footprint. The murderer's, maybe. Weighed on his heel. Took a step back. Fled before the guards arrived. Ran this way. Trail ends here. Strange. Even I couldn't jump this wall.
So, what is it?
Think I know what happened here. Priscilla fought back, her assailant retreated, and knocked over the brazier. Someone must have heard it. Maybe saw something. Started hollering. Guards showed up. Murderer didn't finish the job, didn't cover his tracks. Just collected himself and leapt over the wall. Trail ends there.
You divined all this from a pile of rubbish and a few prints in the mud?
Do that practically every day in my profession. And practice makes perfect.
True enough. Just like I can tell right off if a punt'll pay or try to wriggle out of it.
That particular skill I could use myself. Take care now. And I got a murderer to catch.
Watch it, Tran. No regrets, not your stomping ground.
Oi, beware the gutters.
Oh!
Anyone home?
Be gone! But I'll set me hounds on you. Molly! Striga! Come!
Relax. I'm here about Fabian Meyer, looking for his killer.
That's altogether different. Sit, you stupid mutts. Lie down!
Come on. Go on in. Slowly now, lest they bite you.
Charming as beasts go.
You daft! Even I'm scared of them. But better barking dog than an evil man at your door.
Got someone particular in mind?
Sure as shite. Bugger who did Fabian in. Soon as they'd hauled his corpse off, I run to a mate who raises fighting dogs. Bought these two mutts. Cost me a chunk of change. But I sleep sound, at least.
So who might you be?
The Stiff's brother. Gus is the name. We ran a workshop together. Meyer and Meyer.
What'll it be now? Just Meyer?
Name it. I'll be closing it down now. As soon as I find a buyer for this shack, I'll head on to Mahakam. Be near to my family or what's left of it. So, what do you want to know? What can I tell you about Fabian?
Your brother have any enemies? Anyone dislike him? Threaten him, maybe?
T'was Fabian who threatened this one lass. Oh, you were a good dwarf. Craftsman like no other. But you were an incorrigible whoremonger as well. Whenever we put a bit of coin aside, I'd say, let's buy some tools, quality timber. No, he grabbed the purse and head out whoring. Took to following one in particular. He'd say, "'Tis all your fault, dirty bitch, human dish rag." And other obscenities. Don't rightly know what that was about. Maybe he was in love with her.
Know where I can find her, this dish rag?
City cemetery. She died a few days back, quietly in her sleep. A Ponce de fever took her.
Tell me what you know about the murder, in order, in detail.
It was like this. Had some work in Oxenford, and I was coming home. Saw a plume of smoke rising over the city. Thought to myself, blast it, gonna miss and burn another hag. But the smoke wasn't coming from Hyrax Square. It was coming from here. See the soot stains? That's where they burned our sculptures. Folk gathered round the blaze and found Fabian here beside it. They'd already loaded him on the cart by the time I arrived.
Talk to your neighbours. They see anything suspicious beforehand? Hear anything?
Claim not to. But even if they had, they'd not have helped. In Novigrad, folk give bleating orphans in the street a wide berth so as not to stain their poor lanes. What do they care about some dwarf?
Fine. We've talked enough. Need to look around.
Be my guest. Just beware of the dogs.
Statues of the old gods. Nothing but women. Shapely ones. Stains.
That's where Fabian lay when they found him.
Murderer dragged something heavy.
Dragged something across the floor.
Statues.
More dragged it from one wall to the other, repeatedly.
Mind if I go inside the workshop?
I've not even peeked inside since they found Fabian. But I'll open it for you if you want.
Stains, but not near enough to say he bled to death. Unless somebody got rid of the blood, left a few stains behind. Eyes, humanoid, completely rotten. Furniture got knocked over. This looks like it was kicked. Formaldehyde. Doubt Fabian used it. Nothing here.
Aye.
Had a look at your sculptures.
What? Lifelike, aren't they?
Mm-hmm. The women especially. Never seen a bust that size on Melitele.
Oh, aye. Fabian's handiwork. I told him, brother, tits like that would crush her back. Whittle them down. He said, nay, they'd sell better this way. Told me to shut me trap. And sell they did. Till one sermon at the temple. And the celebrating reverend said that whoso buys idols from the non-human mires sins twofold, as a heretic and as a lecher. That was the end of that.
Already know what happened. Fabian was in the workshop. Murderer attacked him there. They struggled. Fabian was overpowered. Then tortured. For a time.
I needn't know the details. Truth be told, I haven't the stomach for him.
When it was over, the murderer dragged Fabian to the courtyard. Then made a pyre of sculptures, set them aflame.
But why? Why do all that?
To teach a lesson. To him, you, the whole city. Fine, we've talked enough. Won't learn anything else here. Take care.
Many thanks to you, Geralt.
Life's wet enough in the gutter.
A storm, damn it.
Oi, Witcher! Coroner wants to see you. Been another victim. Told me to say the main door will be open for you. You're to come as soon as you can.
Means bandits dropped them. Plain as that.
Bloody bandits! Can't go out in the streets no more!
You Eustace, the corpse collector?
Aye. How'd you know?
Fourth sense, I think it is. You bring Fabian Meyer's body to the morgue?
Fabian? Oh, yeah, I remember. No ice, no art, one of them, right? No purse neither, as I recall.
One of them? So there have been other bodies like that?
Sure have. Beggars, street urchins, and street walkers. One went so poorly, I had to cut her into pieces to fit her in me wheelbarrow. Slippery Sow, they called her, on account of her.
Some things are best left unsaid. What happened to the pieces?
What do you mean? Reverend Nathaniel ordered them burned. Every last one. Oh, shame that was.
Shame? Why? Actually, never mind. Another thing that's best left unsaid. You search Fabian's body?
Whoa. I cost an eye in his pockets. Made sure nothing went to waste.
I call a spade a spade. You rob corpses.
And I call a prick a prick. It's none of your fucking concern. What, you tax collector? Piss off, mutant.
Talk. What did you find on him?
I had you wish. Triflings, baubles, gloss beaded ring, handful of coins, and a letter. Look, vellum, quality parchment that. I'll wipe off the writing and sell it as new.
That's human skin. Priscilla, next victim's name. If you'd given this to the right person, she might not have been hurt.
What the fuck do I care what happens to some Priscilla? We short of wenches in this town. Oi, fucking hell! What was that for?
For everything.
Geralt, right? I'm glad you're here. Held off on the autopsy till you arrived.
Nice of you, especially given you didn't seem pleased about my previous visit.
Because you came unannounced and in unfortunate company. I also had Reverend Nathaniel to contend with. Our spiritual caretaker has left the city on some important matter. And I know who you are, what drives you. I'm more than happy to aid your investigation.
Not fond of Nathaniel?
Very few people are. He's cruel and capricious. He stormed in here once, grabbed a scalpel I was sterilizing over a burner, sliced my back with it to the bone, because I had forgotten to lock the storeroom. Hard to be fond of someone like that, wouldn't you agree?
By the way, you and Von Gratz don't exactly get along. Why is that?
I had him sent to prison. You see, Joachim led the student protests in 1242, a senseless and brutal revolt. People were dying, Witcher. Those who rejected liberty, equality, and fraternity would be found in the gutter come morning. Their throats slit from ear to ear with surgical precision. Joachim had been my favorite student, but alas, I had to do something. So I reported him. Then I left the university and found work in the morgue, where none care about my past. Whereas Joachim, oh, fate's ironies. Years later, he was appointed head of the very ward I had founded.
How old's von Gratz? 50? 60?
53, I believe. Why do you ask?
You look a little young to have been his teacher.
Not surprising. For years, I've lived in the cold and dark, breathing the vapors of embalming fluids. In short, working with corpses extends one's life. Amusing, is it not?
Who's the victim this time?
Joris Aquinas, a lecturer in theology at Oxenfurt Academy. Found this morning at his home on a catafalque made of his books.
Any titles in particular?
It seems all the tomes dealt with the eternal fire. Treatise critical of the faith's doctrines.
Yeah, mortal sin in Novigrad. Let's start.
Gladly. The wounds conform to the killer's modus operandi. The victim was bound and forced to drink formaldehyde. Next, the killer removed the eyes, placed burning coals in the sockets, then opened the rib cage and... What's this? A parchment made of human skin.
A message from the murderer, the name of his next victim. Patricia Vagelbud.
Do you know her?
Yes. Even went to her estate once with... Gotta find her, now.
Till next time, Master.
I just...
Move it!
Wounds.
Need to talk to Patricia Vagelbud.
You think any bum off the street can...
Her life's in danger. Let me in or have her blood on your hands.
If you thought this up, and I'll let you in, I'll throw my arse out the door.
Always thought a guard was supposed to protect his charge, not his ass.
So be it. I'll take you to Lady Vagelbud. Just no trickery. Understand?
Geralt, what a pleasant surprise.
Not pleasant at all. I gotta see your mother. Her life's in danger.
In danger? Come now. I saw Mother this morning. She seems sad, true, but in perfect health.
I'm hunting a serial killer, and I've got reason to believe your mother will be his next victim.
Why, even if it's true, our gods...
He's exceptionally cruel when he kills, tortures his victims, cuts out their hearts. So let's see how she is, just in case.
I find this all very hard to believe, but you appear to be quite serious. Please, follow me.
A fire fit for Beltane, except it's the wrong time of year.
I mentioned Mother seems sad. Do you remember? In fact, she's in the midst of a crisis of faith. A rather serious one. We'd been to Novigrad. Mother had seen the pyres in Hierarch Square, uttered not a word on our way home. She had all the holy books, insignias, reliquaries gathered, taken outside and burnt. Then she locked herself in her room.
We need to hurry.
Those sadists ought to change their name now to non-human hunters.
Hear that? Calm and quiet. All seems to be in order.
We should go in, just to be sure.
You're relentless, aren't you? Fine. But wait here, please. Mother's certainly not in the mood for guests.
Ah! He
still here. Between your eyes.
Listen, you got the wrong guy.
Save your trickery, taking you to the heiress.
Well, killer's already escaped. Lead the way, hero.
We got him, Lady Ingrid. Wasn't easy, but...
Lower that crossbow before you hurt yourself. This man is innocent.
Forgive me. I saw him running. Thought it was the killer fleeing.
I was chasing him, and I'd have caught him if you hadn't gotten in my way.
Out of my sight, at once! Mother! Why did he do this to her? Why?
Because she blasphemed the eternal fire, only thing that ties her to the other victims. Ingrid. I know this is a hard time for you, but usually the killer leaves a note on the body, a note indicating his next victim. May I?
Very well. But you should be on your own. I do not wish to see her in this state. I do not wish to remember her like that. And let her be the last victim. Please.
Bruises, broken fingernails. She defended herself. Must be why it took him longer, and why he almost got caught. Here it is. Sweet Nettie, crippled Cates. Growing bolder, not just the name, but the place too. Won't get away this time. Same wounds as the previous victims. Examination would be a waste of time. Gotta get to crippled Cates, fast.
Upstairs, but she's with a very important client. Do not disturb them.
The thinking customer will see right away I've got the best deals this side of the pond.
No one will hear you, bitch. Not a soul.
You, though? Whole town will hear you in a minute.
Yet again you disturb me. And I so dislike being disturbed. I was to play with sweet Nettie, render her not so sweet, but I shall see to you first.
What, no foreplay? No formaldehyde? Coals in my eye sockets?
What the fuck are you on about?
Murder. You killed Fabian Meyer, Patricia Vagelbud, and many others.
Bollocks. You're mistaken, vagrant.
Found a message on Patricia's body. Led me here to crippled Kate's. To sweet Nettie. If you didn't leave it, who did?
I don't know. But I see we must talk. Calmly.
Who knew you'd be here?
Strangely enough, I don't announce these outings far and wide. There's but one man who... That's impossible. He treats even corpses with kid gloves.
The coroner. Said you were busy, that you wouldn't visit the morgue. Gotta go after him.
Go. But to Warehouse 12 at the docks. He's there this time of day, procuring supplies. Formaldehyde. I shall stay here. I've unfinished business with sweet Nettie. After all, I paid in advance.
Then you'll pay again. For her, for all the other women you've tortured. You're free now.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. If not for you. He asked if I did everything and I said, for the right price, of course. And then he smiled. Oh, God, it gave me the shivers. And then he hit me so hard I passed out. I was bound when I came to. And he was hitting a poker in the fire.
Calm down. He won't hurt you anymore. He won't hurt anyone. Out of formaldehyde.
I underestimated you. You almost caught me in flagrante delicto. Now you've seen through my bluff with Nathaniel. Although, you've not divined all, I see. Had you, you would have drawn your silver sword.
Who, what are you?
A vampire. Hire, of course.
Got a reason for killing? A reason to torture? I thought you'd figure that out as well. The symbolism's rather obvious. Coals for those who are blind to the fire. The egg of a salamander born of fire to replace their cold, doubting hearts. Fire down the throat that...
Yeah, symbolism's clear. What's not is why a vampire would kill in the name of the eternal fire.
Should be equally obvious. I concur with the church's diagnosis. Novigrad is a fallen city. Its population amnesiacs to the very concepts of decency and morality. So I decided to remind them, in a manner they'd be certain to notice.
Tortured logic.
Yet logic, nonetheless. I'm glad you perceived that, at least. Fight fire with fire, as they say. Give a thought to my victims. A lecherous woodcarver who'd spend his last copper on whores. An old countess who defiled symbols of the faith. A Trebiritz for whom nothing was sacred, nothing above ridicule. They did not deserve to live. But their deaths could be a lesson to others. Awaken them, scare them onto the correct path, the path to the fire, to cleansing, to salvation. For you, I'm afraid it's too late. You are a man of little faith. I sense this.
Mm-hmm. But I'm pretty good with a sword.
Pretty good. Might not cut it.
Yes, Geralt?
Found and killed the murderer. It was Hubert. You were right not to trust him. He was a higher vampire.
I thought nothing could surprise me in Novigrad. Seems I was wrong. Deeply wrong. Thank you, Geralt. Were it not for you, this would never have ceased.
Hubert told me about your past, even more vivid than I'd assumed.
I've not time for riddles, Geralt. Be straight or be gone.
Any truth to his claim that people died during the riots at the university? Died for your cause?
I was young and stupid. I thought a better future was worth any price. Even a human life or two. But those are past sins. Sins I've atoned for.
Why is the university in Oxenford closed?
Because it suits Radovid. You've not heard the story? The rector wished to grant him an honorary doctorate. The faculty disagreed. Nonetheless, Radovid arrived for the ceremony, donned a gown, collected his diploma, and when it was over, imprisoned the deans and the entire academic senate so they wouldn't raise a stink.
I've been at Vilmerius Hospital ever since. But perhaps it's for the best. I'm far more adept, scalpel in hand, than I ever was behind a lectern.
Know another surgeon from Oxenford Academy. Her name's Shani. Know her? Red hair, cropped short, freckles.
And a hopeless idealist. Naturally, I know her. She was my assistant for a year.
Any idea where she is now?
My gut tells me she's somewhere along the front, patching up pikemen. I told her it would be futile. In the time she saved 100 lives, another 1,000 would be lost. But medics with a mission, you can't argue with them.
Farewell. How's?
Better, right?
Yes.
Did you take care of what I asked?
Yeah. The Witcher's way.
Thank you, Geralt. From me and Priscilla.
Did my part. Your turn now. Take care of her. Good care.
I will. You'll see. Treat her better than the Dryads of Brockamon could.
She's talking again. Nice surprise.
Isn't it? Professor Von Gratz told me her wounds are healing faster than a troll's. Not the most flattering comparison, but encouraging. Maybe she might even sing again someday. For now, we'll try performing as a duo. She'll play the lute, I'll sing. Dandelion and Calanetta. Got a nice ring to it, doesn't it?
Sounds great. Good luck, Dandelion. On stage and off.